Hey, what's up, guys? This is Isaacs. This week's topic is talking about whether or not we're happy where we are in our transition. Me personally, as far as the point of transition that I'm at right now, I'm not fully happy with it. And I'd be lying to say that I was happy where I'm at right now. Excuse me for the chair noise. I'm taking a seat. Okay, so as far as my transition goes, I'm not satisfied where I'm at right now at this point in my transition. As far as everything that can be done with injections, for the most part, I am happy with where I'm at, but at the same time, I'm not. I'm over 3 years on T, and I feel like some people have better results within the first year than I've had in three. What I mean by that is just, like, I wish my beard would grow higher and my mustache would fill in eventually, but my mustache still just peeks through a little bit. I mean, I know I pass, so that I'm pleased with, but, you know, I don't think we're ever satisfied with where we're at. And that's just realistically speaking. Also, aside from just the hormones and my transition where I'm at, I'm really ready for surgery. And it's still a little ways off. It's not too far off. I'm actually pretty happy about where I'm at right now. It's just a little ways out. I had set it for mid-January. And I put a deposit down, set a date, and then the price changed. So now the price is about $1,300 higher than I was going to be because they're telling me I need an extended cut. So I need to get my date pushed back just a little so that I have time to make up that difference. Unless I do some type of benefit or something and raise those funds, I'm gonna have to postpone the surgery. So I've emailed who I've been in contact with from the surgeon's office to see if I could get another date set. And I still haven't gotten a response yet. It's been about almost 2 weeks that I haven't gotten a response back on them to see if a date's available the week that I was looking at. So that's one thing that I'm not thrilled about, is just not being able to be fully free yet. I am happy that it will be done at the beginning of next year, but upset that it's not done yet. Other than that, though, there's not too many other things that I really feel like I need right this second. I mean, eventually I'll have to do a histo. Haven't had that done yet. Maybe that will help with the mustache coming in, you know, might help with my facial hair growing up a little bit. I am happy, though, that fortunately, my genetics and my family, all the men still have hair. And my grandpa's 90 and still has hair. He just lost light right here in these edges. So I think I'll be all right with that. I still have a full head of hair. So that part I'm happy about. But I wish some changes would, like, kick in a little bit better, you know? My voice, I still don't feel is, like, really masculine. But I don't have issues with it. It's just, it's not as deep as I would like it to be. And I would like to drop some weight again. My weight fluctuates quite a bit. Over the past, like, 4 years, it's always fluctuated within, like, a 40-pound radius where I'll jump up or I'll jump down. Right now, I'm somewhere in the middle of that 40-pound radius, but I do want to get lower than that. Overall, I want to lose 40 pounds from what I am right now. So hopefully when surgery happens, I'll work towards meeting that goal. And I feel like a lot of T guys do that. They have surgery and then they, like, really start dropping weight or really start focusing on hitting the weights and, like, building everything up and toning everything up. So I'm gonna try to get that done. Don't know how that's gonna go. I've always been a bigger guy, but we'll see. Other than that, as far as, like, my transition and just being happy, I'm pretty much happy with myself. I'm not too dysphoric about much. I do still have dysphoria about the restrooms. And I think that's kind of normal, though. You know, I always feel like someone's watching the placement of my feet. Like, when I go to the stall, are they watching that my feet are placed forward? And yes, I have a STP, but I don't fully trust it because I haven't used it enough to where I've been fully used to it yet. I don't want it to, like, back up on me and hit my thigh and me be out in public somewhere and not able to do anything about situating that situation. So, you know, I wish that that wasn't an issue. But my license and name, gender are already updated, so I'm happy about that. That took a while to get done. My school has my name. My social security's been updated. You know, almost all my stuff's been updated. The only thing I haven't really updated yet is my birth certificate, and I haven't changed my car title over to the new name or my insurance. Which, I don't know, guys, have y'all heard about, like, with the car insurance that supposedly it goes up under
male names? And
that kind of worries me because it went up on its own already, but I have a sports car. So I can only imagine what it's going to go up to if that's the case.
But I'm also in my
30s, early 30s.
So maybe it won't be
too bad, but I know I got to get that taken care of.
So other than that,
there really
isn't much that I have issues with, though. I hate to be misgendered.
And that still happens from time to time.
And that's just, like,
more so at my job. And that's because I came out later to them with the name change and everything. So I still get some employees that
don't work in the office that still call me by my old name. People that just don't know that it's been changed. But I'm slowly getting them to refer to me the proper way. So, I mean, I don't know, like,
but I don't really
know how to hone in
on what really bothers me as far as, like, where I'm at in my transition, besides just really wanting my
surgery done already. Which that I do plan to
log for y'all guys. I got a new camera that
I could kind of log that a little bit better.
Maybe I'll load that to my personal channel for anyone who might be curious about
that. I will be going to Doolin and Plano for that. Has anyone else had the extended cuts? And if you have,
did that raise the price of your surgery?
But, okay guys, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this video up, and I will see y'all next week.